How to create a real-time dashboard with Excel files. Building dashboards is a key element for any business's decision-making process. Dashboards provide at-a-glance views of KPIs to understand performance and measure objectives. It incorporates historical data with real-time information that is useful for identifying emerging trends and monitoring efficiency. But where do we keep this data? Excel files are great for storing data. They also make it easy to manually enter and update data entries. However, it has its limitations. When it comes to storing and processing large amounts of data, it can be slow and even impossible to do. Excel's limitations become a problem when dealing with real-time data. As the volume of data you're storing increases over time, Excel will have a harder time storing it. Instead, you can use databases to store the data you need to build your dashboard. Using ACCO, I'll show you how you can build a real-time dashboard with Excel files. The first step is to create your resource. You can upload a single file or batch files. When uploading batch files, make sure all of the files have the same set of columns. I'm going to go ahead and upload several batch files. Before uploading, you'll see a preview of the table. In the upper right corner, you'll see toggles for Auto Detect and Safe Mode. Auto Detect will automatically detect each column's name and type. If you're having issues with that, use Safe Mode, which will deal with most errors. If you'd like more granular options, uncheck both, and you'll be able to rename and set your own types. If everything looks all right, go ahead and click Upload, and your resource will be created. At this stage, you've created a database from your Excel files. Next, to view and transform your data, upload the resource into a project. In the project, you'll have access to a variety of tools, such as filtering, joining tables, pivoting tables, and cleaning data. You can also calculate new columns and, if you're experienced with SQL, use the SQL editor to craft more complex actions. Let's see one of these tools in action. I know that I want one of my charts to display average sales each month. Right now, my order date contains the day, month, and year. Using formulas and consulting the SQL function documentation on the right, I'm going to create a new column with just the month and year. Once your data is ready, head over to the charting app to create your dashboard. You can easily add a chart from a project. Select the project you want to use and the table within it. Then pick the type of chart you want to build. Next, configure your chart. In the dimensions, pick the column you'd like to use as your x-axis. You can choose additional breakdown dimensions as well to group your data. The metric will be your y-axis values. You can choose different aggregation methods such as sum or average. You can also choose additional filters to narrow down your data set for this chart without changing your project. Then, choose either ascending or descending to sort your x-axis. In the Formats tab, you can name and configure your titles and axes. You can also create data labels, legends, goal lines, and adjust your point markers. I'm going to name my chart and rename my axes. This is what my chart looks like. Now we're on our way to build our dashboard. Now let's say I just received new data. How do I update my dashboard? Go back to Resources and navigate to File Management. Here is where you can add and remove files from your batch resource. When adding new files, make sure that your columns are the same. Then we go back into our project and we click on the Data Sync button. Once the new files we added are synced to the project, go back to the dashboard and you'll see that your charts have been updated to reflect the changes.